So hello everyone. So welcome to the channel of RD Automation Learning. And today we are going to discuss with one of the candidate, Aruna, who has recently got a job. And let us learn from her what approach, what strategy did she took to get a job in QA. So I would like to welcome Aruna from the entire team of RD Automation Learning. So Aruna, how are you?
Hi. Thanks for the opportunity. Yes, I'm good.
Okay, Aruna. So thank you for joining. Okay. And how's your health now?
Yeah, it's fine. Good.
Okay. So Aruna, can you tell us what job opportunity you have got? Like, is it a manual testing job or an automation testing job?
Manual tester. I am a manual tester. And I got job in Neosoft Technologies for location Mumbai.
Okay, great. Great.
As of now, I'm working in my hometown.
Okay, you are doing work from home currently.
Work from home. Okay. Yep, yep.
So congratulations, first of all, Aruna.
Thank you.
Yeah. So would you like to tell us more about the interview process and what are all the testing questions were asked over there?
Yes. Interview process, it's of like two technical rounds. We'll have some, you know, telephonic round only. Mm-hmm. And the third one will be the head of the tester department in that company, I mean, of that company. He'll call us on Skype or whatever, and he'll be asking some questions. And next will be some sort of package discussion round or something like that, some HR round.
Right.
Yeah, total of four rounds, two technical with telephone and one with Skype or Zoom with HR, I mean, HOT of that company. And other round, last round will be a HR kind of discussion round.
Right. So how many years of experience you have?
I have 1 year, 9 months of experience, and my previous company is Accenture.
Okay, great. So yeah. Since how you were, looking for a switch, how much time did you took to switch from one company to another?
I mean, after completing my last day in Accenture only, I started looking for a job because my project there was so heavy and I couldn't get time to prepare anything in my that kind of notice period. Mm-hmm. So once I'm done with my project and all, and I, you know, gave my desktop over there in Chennai, then I started preparing. Till then, those 3 months in my notice period, I didn't have time to learn or to prepare anything.
Okay.
So once I'm done with all the formalities in my previous company, then itself I started, you know, looking for a job, and it took like 1 month to get a new job.
Right. Okay, so what all things did you prepare for your interview? How did you prepare for an interview?
Interview preparation, first thing, whatever skill, we might have so much of skill, but the thing is we need to get kind of opportunity to prove ourselves. Rather, we need to get some call from a company that we're going to schedule an interview. That is the first thing which matters while looking for a job. Absolutely. Everyone might have skill, but no one will think that, okay, if people will call me for an interview, then I have skill, I can tell. That is not the way. First point is we need to get a call scheduled from a company, any company. Getting a call scheduled is the first hurdle everyone will face.
Mm-hmm.
So that is what I thought this is main for me. And I use LinkedIn for that. LinkedIn okay. helped a lot.
Okay.
And I should say it will help for everyone. Like I used to be in LinkedIn mainly for around some 8 hours a day. Like even when I'm sleeping, I used to wake up in the middle and I used to see if any job postings of tester are there, or if someone will give their phone number, we can contact them directly. Something like that. Connections, we need to establish a good connection over in LinkedIn so that we'll have n number of chances to get an interview call scheduled.
Right.
Then we can, I think Neosoft is my second company where I got interviewed. First one I didn't select that. Like, I don't know, I didn't get time to get myself prepared to an interview. And this is the second company and I got selected there.
No problem. So you were using LinkedIn almost for 8 to 10 hours. So that is than Facebook and Instagram as well.
Yeah. Even that is what I said to my friends. I'm using LinkedIn like how we use Instagram.
Hmm.
Yes.
Right. So what all the technical round was there, right, in the company? So what all questions were asked? Were they asked totally on all on testing, or they asked for agile as well?
In HR round, they didn't ask me any questions like what to say, any questions regarding testing. But in my technical rounds, just they asked whether, I mean, no, other than technical questions, they asked whether are you ready to relocate to Mumbai, because I'm from Andhra Pradesh and it'll take some 26 hours for me to travel.
Right.
Yeah, they asked even if you call suddenly, are you okay to travel and all. And yeah, rest all are in, and technical round questions are almost like, what did you do in your previous company? What is your role as a tester there in your previous company?
Mm-hmm.
And like, what kind of testing methods you followed there? Which kind of method, like whether it is agile or whatever model?
Okay.
And yeah, I mean, what kind of tools you used for testing?
Mm-hmm.
And different, basically they asked about the basic difference. See, people will get confused between difference between sanity testing, regression testing, smoke testing.
Mm-hmm.
So I faced n number of interviews. I mean, every person, every interview guy used to ask me this question, difference between sanity, smoke and regression testing.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of you, what is an UAT testing?
Okay.
Basic definitions, we'll think like now basic definitions only we can manage as we have experience. I the first interview I faced, I used to face like, chalo, I have an experience. I don't think so people might ask me this.
Okay.
No, they'll ask both. They'll ask about our experience, what we did on floor in a company, and also the basic knowledge. One needs to have basic knowledge along with their experience.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let's say if you're using LinkedIn, so mm-hmm. what all things you used to do? Like you used to search for the jobs, or how you used to search for a job on LinkedIn?
Okay, I used to search in that search bars in saying like something regarding some term regarding testing.
Okay.
Testing, and I'll get some kind of suggestions who are so looking for a tester profile.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to connect request them. I mean, I used to send a connection request.
Okay.
If at all they might not have an opening in their company, you might not have an opening in your company,
mm-hmm.
but some of your connections might post for the same.
Mm-hmm.
And you can comment like, commenting and ash my name, saying commenting Aruna Santoshi for better reach, so that it will reach me, or else I can see the post which one of your connections might have posted.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, we'll have something like helping hands. Those people will help us a lot in getting, they just collect all the posts which are required for a car testing or whatever. And they'll keep it with them so that everyone who are in their connections, they can see.
Okay.
And yeah, I joined all some kind of testing groups. I joined, this learning testing group after completing my second round, actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that was too good. So you actually used LinkedIn to get a job on of QA.
Okay. Yeah,
that is absolutely, that is wonderful. That is mind blowing. Generally, people don't understand the importance of LinkedIn. They will send some vague messages to the people out there, but actually, it is the right manner. It is the right manner to use LinkedIn whenever you are searching for the jobs or you want to share something to the community. You want to share some knowledge to the people out there, or you want to share your experience, what all things you are using in your organization, new things, new stuff, new technologies. LinkedIn is a absolute perfect platform for that.
Yes.
So there were two technical rounds. So you were asked these questions like regression testing, sanity smoke testing. Okay, the differences between them.
Differences between, and when can a tester start regression testing?
When a tester can start.
When is it possible?
Scenario,
is it
whether situation for... based questions were asked.
Sorry?
Situation based question. Scenario
situation,
based
question. Yes. Like, is it regression testing is done before UAT testing or after UAT testing?
Okay.
This kind of questions.
Right. Those were asked over there. No problem. That is absolutely fine. You are in a home. Even
No. She's mobbing the floor. That's why I'm asking her not to come.
Okay. So Aruna, do you have any tips or tricks to be given to the people out there, to the community? People are getting demotivated. They are telling me that they apply to a lot of jobs, but they don't get calls. So
you don't believe me. I used to keep around some 27 mails per day, and I used to call some 12-13 people per day.
Okay.
it's not like everyone whom we have sent resume might require you know the people require us. That is what.
Right. So people, they'll get.
You can.
Yeah, so 27 mails per day you used to send. You used to apply in per day itself.
Yeah. Okay. So in only LinkedIn, I'm telling in LinkedIn. I'm not telling about what all I applied on what to say Naukri and all. Naukri is like I used to apply so many, but I didn't get any response from Naukri, and I'm saying it on public.
Right. So generally, you know, these things happen with many people out there during the pandemic, during the COVID-19 also. You know, many people were laid off. So they used to keep on applying jobs, and then they used to get demotivated. Even we used to tell them that we used to keep them motivated, that you keep on applying. There'll be one day when you'll get a call, your CV would get shortlisted. Sometimes the keywords are not being properly written in the resume. That guy would have worked so much on testing, but there is only one keyword of QA or testing. So his resume or her resume might not get shortlisted also.
Yes.
That is also the case. Okay, so any other success mantra that you would like to share with us?
Success mantra? I don't think so. People get demotivated soon. If even 3-4 months you are there in this job trials, no matter, we get a job for sure, because every project, every company needs a tester. Things are developing, and of course they should need a tester. It's not like tester's job is less testers are less required. Whether it is QA or whether it is manual, a company or a project requires a tester. That is a fact. And yes, testers do have so many jobs. And one thing is, rather than people cannot open each and every resume, so in order to know what kind of experience you have, whether it is QA or manual or automation, instead of writing only our name, you can say, example, XYZ is your name, XYZ hyphen 1 year 10 month experience hyphen manual QA. If your name of the resume is in this way, people will say, okay, I want a tester of 1+ year experience, and this girl or boy might fit into it. Let me open it. If you simply keep Arna Santoshi in your resume and without any experience or role, they don't know. They don't get time to open each and every resume, because they might get people in the 10-20 resumes they have got, and they don't even look into the others one.
Yeah, that is absolutely true. Name with a years of experience mentioned in the file name, and it is very helpful to the recruiter, not only for this job position, but it is useful for the upcoming in the future as well. After 6 months, if they look into their database, so they'll be able to track it more properly.
Yes. And every company will have their career portal. Mm-hmm. Of course, it will take time for companies like MNCs to get interview call. Of course, it will take time, because in career portal, n number of people will apply. But even I applied for Infosys. Once I got this Neosoft offer letter and I joined, the next day I got an interview call for Infosys. And I said, I can't. I already joined any other company. Mm-hmm. So each and every company will have a career portal. And yeah, we should create an account there, and you know, we should apply. It's not like every company will give an option to easy apply in LinkedIn. And if you click on easy apply, we'll automatically get applied. But so many companies, we need to have an account in their company portal. Mm-hmm. For that, we need to sign in. People will feel like it is a lengthy process, but yes, it will be helpful. Within a month, you will get at least one call from those companies which you applied on their company portal to get an interview call.
Right, definitely. So, would you like to add something?
Add something into questions. Technical questions are very common, like what all the basic differences. It's not like definitions. Some kind of differences, and when can we do this testing? When can we do this sort of testing? Are the one which I faced in both of my technical rounds.
Okay. So the difference is like regression versus retesting, smoke versus sanity,
sanity versus testing, stress testing. Yes.
These kind of differences.
Yes.
You will be telling more to prepare. Okay.
Difference between stress testing, load testing, functional testing, non-functional testing, and who does which mean well whether developers will do smoke test or whether SAT testers will do smoke test. These kind of questions.
Right. Okay. Yeah. So thank you so much for sharing your experience, Aruna. It was wonderful talking to you and having you on the channel as well. Okay. So thank you so much for joining, Aruna.
Ignore those background things over there.
No problem. It's a home. We are working all from home. So no issues. We are all human. We are all human beings. We have a family to support. So no issues.
Yeah.